This is CNN Breaking News.
We have some breaking news for you as we watch Air Force One. It just landed at Joint Base Andrews in Maryland. We're waiting for President Trump to come out. He has just announced a major staff change in his White House, tweeting just seconds ago, "I am pleased to inform you that I have just named General/Secretary John F. Kelly, that is the Secretary of the Department of Homeland Security, as White House Chief of Staff. He is a great American, dot, dot, dot." Presumably more is coming in this announcement, but 3 minutes ago, that is what he tweeted. We are waiting for more information about what this means. Obviously, Reince Priebus was, until 3 minutes ago, as far as we knew, the White House Chief of Staff. Let us go to Sarah Murray at the White House now, who can tell us more on this breaking story. And Sarah, so much is announced via tweet these days. One wonders what kind of preparation anybody inside the White House knew about this. What can you tell us?
Well, look, we have been hearing from people last night as well as this morning that the president was not happy with his chief of staff, that he was being encouraged by people around him, including members of his family who are his senior advisors, Jared Kushner and Ivanka Trump, that it was time to make a change. They didn't feel like Reince Priebus was up to the job of chief of staff. There were some close to the president who felt like Priebus wasn't carrying out the president's wishes, that he wasn't effective in calming the West Wing chaos and power struggle, but that he also wasn't shepherding the president's agenda through Congress. And obviously he had the president suffered a health care defeat last night. That was just a part of what we're talking about here. Now, allies that are close to Priebus were insistent today that the chief of staff would be safe. They were insistent that Priebus would not be resigning. So it was pretty clear that if there was going to be a change, it was something the president was going to have to decide to do. He was going to actively fire his chief of staff. So far, at least on Twitter, we don't have a good indication of what happens next to Reince Priebus. Obviously, we'll look for more details on that, Jake.
All right, Sarah, thank you so much. Bring us back more reporting when you get it. I'm joined now by David Chalian. David, first of all, happy American Heroes Week.
Yeah.
Because that was the theme of this week, according to the White House, although the focus has been on almost everything but American heroes. And here we have this tweet at 4:50 on a Friday evening announcing that the Department of Homeland Security Secretary, retired Marine General John Kelly, a very respected man in Washington, D.C., that he is now the White House Chief of Staff.
And remember when the president was putting together his team during the transition, you remember his talk of how much he appreciated the generals, loved the generals, and put together with McMaster came in afterwards and Mattis and Kelly. This was sort of the core that was supposed to calm the waters of concerns among Republicans and other Washington establishment types. The question I have, Jake, last I checked, you can change chiefs of staff. The president is still the person who's in the Oval Office. It is his impulses. It is his direction. It is his focus on things, or decidedly distracted focus on things, that have been setting the tone. His Twitter feed. Is Secretary Kelly coming in as chief of staff going to stop tweets that roil the waters here in Washington? That's unclear to me. Obviously, we'll have a lot to learn about how Priebus learned about this. Did he learn about it from this tweet that he is out of this job? But this one move alone does not seem likely to me to all of a sudden calm the waters into a fully functioning White House.
And let me just read, because President Trump, 5 minutes after the first part of the tweet, which was, "I am pleased to inform you that I have just named General/Secretary John F. Kelly as White House Chief of Staff. He is a great American, dot, dot, dot." He now has tweeted the second part, "and a great leader," capitalized for some reason. "John has also done a spectacular job at Homeland Security. He has been a true star of my administration." David, Secretary Kelly, who we should again remind people is a very respected retired Marine general, serving as Homeland Security Secretary, was on Air Force One with President Trump as he flew to New York today for this speech, these remarks he gave in front of a bunch of law enforcement officers talking about the threat of the vile gang MS-13. It did not seem unusual for John Kelly, Secretary Kelly, to be on that flight. Homeland Security obviously is focused on combating gangs such as MS-13 and stopping undocumented immigrants from coming into this country and joining gangs like MS-13. But it is certainly interesting timing, given, as we know, how impulsive President Trump can be.
And what we don't know is how John Kelly is going to come in and run this White House differently. Will he have the real latitude to do so? That remains unknown. You know who else was on Air Force One today? Was Reince Priebus.
Right.
And the current chief of staff. So it's unclear just when he was informed about this, how he found out about this. This change is important. Donald Trump is clearly cleaning house. He understands what he was doing. So thus far is not working. John Kelly, as you noted, is running a department that actually is enacting some of the more successful areas of the Trump agenda.
Sure, the border crossings
exactly.
have lessened, and the wall, the first funding tranche was approved, I think.
So he's looking to a place where some of his agenda is actually getting enacted and moving forward, and now bringing that person inside the West Wing.
Jeff Zeleny is at the White House for us as well. And Jeff, people in the White House are learning about this via tweet. Just as the rest of us are.
It's right, Jake. I've been talking to a couple senior administration officials and other staffers here since this news came out. And at least according to them, this is coming as a surprise to them as well. One of the best ways, of course, to keep a secret and to avoid leaks, and this did not leak, is to not tell anyone. And it appears that's what the president did, at least not many people, as he was flying back to Joint Base Andrews, as we see Air Force One sitting right there. So this is coming as a major surprise to people here at the White House. Jake, first and foremost, the people who are close to Reince Priebus had absolutely no idea this was happening. We've been talking to them throughout the day as we've been reporting that the president was being urged to have a change in the chief of staff's office. And they insisted that he's not going anywhere. They insisted that Reince Priebus was going to stick this out and in fact was going to weather this storm. Well, that is not how this is ending up, Jake. And Reince Priebus has had a famous phrase that became a little bit rote over the past few months. He said, look, I have nine lives, whenever anyone asked him about his role as chief of staff. Well, it appears that he used up, I think, most of those nine, Jake, perhaps even more than that. But his loyalists, people who came here to the White House from the Republican National Committee, where he had been the chairman for so many years, are finding this very shocking, in fact, in the words of one. So it'll be interesting to see, Jake, how many more RNC staffers follow him out the door, Jake.
All right, Jeff Zeleny, thank you so much. A tumultuous day. President Trump, in this first 6 months, has gotten rid of his national security advisor, his communications director, his press secretary, and as of just a few minutes ago, his White House chief of staff. Wolf Blitzer is in the Situation Room. Thanks for watching. I'll see you Sunday on State of the Union.